told your friend you're not okay. And tell me what's wrong and why you never said you felt that way. And guess you're trying to stay strong and fake a smile until I look.
What's up, guys? It's your girl, Fade Into the Vote. If you don't know, you will. If you're new to my channel, welcome. If you're returning to my channel, welcome back. You already know the vibes. Your girl loves you for all the support that y'all continuously show me. I feel much appreciated. Y'all don't even know. Like, I'm trying mad hard not to cry. Like, y'all already know I've been dealing with depression for quite some time now. And then for some reason lately, I've been really under the pressure, I've been really feeling so much pressure, like, with everything from my kids to work to just dealing with myself and putting that self-care in for myself, putting that time in for myself. Bro, I'm trying to be consistent, super transparent with you guys on what's going on. I want to be posting more, so I want to, you know, bring awareness to mental health, because that shit is no joke, guys. It's really no joke. I really be feeling like I do too much. I feel like there's no stopping. I feel like shit most of the time, and it's crazy because I'm such a bubbly person. I'm such a fun person. I'm always making the next person happy, and I'm always there for other people. You feel what I'm saying? But then when I'm going through my mental, I just don't feel the same thing is reciprocated back to me. And that goes from each corner. It's like from friends, family. Like, I don't feel that being reciprocated. And I know a lot of people won't agree with that, because they'll feel like, oh, well, I called you and I talked to you. But it's not the same. It's not the same. I'm, like, really trying to fight back tears, because back to school's around the corner. I'm getting super stressed out. Y'all know I'm, like, always trying to do everything, trying to be super mom, and try not to have it faze my kids. So I try to do everything I can for them, you know, behind the scenes, and make sure they got, you know, when I have my kids, I always say I'm going to do everything I can to make sure I provide for my kids, no matter what, whether their father's involved or not, which their father is involved, but he doesn't do as much as I do. Like, he doesn't, let me not speak on him, because that's a whole nother video, but he's there. But then it's like, I gotta be mommy to everybody, you know. I gotta tell everybody what to do, when to do it, how to do it, you know. And it's frustrating sometimes, because it's like, when do I get time for myself? I don't get, a lot of people get to go on trips, a lot of people get to take staycation, a lot of people get time to, like, bring their kids to their grandparents, and they stay at their grandparents for a while, so they can have time for themselves to take care of their mental health. I really don't have that opportunity. I really don't. Because it's like, one minute I get the, oh, I'm gonna help you out, and the next one I gotta iterate that I need help every minute. And it's super frustrating. Like, I'm super overwhelmed. Like, it's not even funny. Like, and I hate that I cope with depression in the weirdest way, because one minute I'll just, like, bury everything down, and then the next minute it just come bursting right back up, and it hits me like a ton of bricks. Or I can have a great day, and all of a sudden it hits me like a ton of bricks, and I have to deal with those emotions right then and there. It's super frustrating. I'm not on medication, because I feel like once I start taking medication, that'll be something that I will always have to take. And I don't want to become addicted to a drug that I don't know what's in them. I don't know what it really does for you. I don't know the long terms. And if you notice, a lot of antidepressants these days, years later, end up having some type of side effect that fucks with you. And I don't want that. I really don't. I wanted to do it naturally. I do go to therapy once a week, sometimes twice a week, depending on the week that I had. And my therapist is amazing. I love her. She's very understanding. She's very patient. And she's literally helped me figure out different coping mechanisms to deal with me being depressed. And I'm trying to stay consistent with my business. I'm trying to, I want to be in a place in life where I'm not here. I'm not in this moment. You know what I'm saying? So it's super frustrating when you look at yourself and you see yourself in a place where you are now to the place where you thought you would be. And it's how do you get to that point? And you're working so hard and it's it's super frustrating. But you know, I mental health is something that everybody needs to check on. Everybody needs to check on their friends. Everybody needs to literally take a step back from their life and literally make sure that the people in their circle, the people around them, are okay, because people take their lives every day. And not saying that I would ever do that. I would never rob my kids of their mom. But it's just super frustrating. I'm not gonna lie, it's been thought about, you know. But it's just I know my limit, and that is one limit I will not take. That's one avenue I will not turn to, because I have an obligation to my kids to be here, to provide, to be there for them, to take care of them, to make sure that they're okay, to live their best life, and, you know, have a great childhood other than what I had. You know what I'm saying? I had a good childhood for the most part, but I want to make sure that they don't go through the same shit that I've been through. You feel what I'm saying? And it goes to show you how deep my feelings are for my family. Everybody know I'm one of the person that's big on family. I'm big on family. I cannot just turn my back on family members. I cannot just shit on people. I can't just be this evil bitch to my family. Friends and associates and whatnot, that's different. But when it comes to my family, I take that shit so serious. I would stress myself out to make sure that my family has, you know what I'm saying? So it's just knowing that I'm that, everything affects me times 10. Everything. When I can't get something done, when something gets canceled, when I have to go somewhere and it doesn't turn out, it hits me so bad. And I don't want to keep going through this anymore. Depression is a best friend that I don't want. Dead ass. It's just a person that's there leeching on my feelings, and it sucks the life out of me sometimes, because certain things, the littlest things, I feel the littlest things would set me over. And I'm just damn, I see myself going over that bridge. I see myself going on a downward spiral, and I just can't catch myself in time. Comment down below, do you guys, anyone that's suffering from depression, do y'all go through that? What are some mechanisms that y'all guys use? What are some coping mechanisms y'all use that could literally help me out? Because I'm at the point where I just don't know. You know what I'm saying? I look crazy. Well, not too crazy. I just got off of work, and it's just yo, this whole week, I finally posted up a video. Go check it out. I posted up a video yesterday, and I'm you know what? Let me just pick up the camera and just talk to you guys, because I am supposed to be editing and put out another video right away, because I want to be consistent. I want to be more, you know, active on my YouTube channel. So I'm you know what, let me bite the bullet and do a good deed for myself, and that's recording, you know, my emotions, and maybe a touch one of you guys, you know, that's going through the same thing, you know, because support is big, and I believe in support, and support goes a long way. So yeah, guys, I just wanted to share that with you guys. So if you guys are dealing with depression, And y'all don't have no one there to turn to, you guys. You know, seek help. Go to therapy. It does help. Try talking to someone. If you can't talk to someone, talk to your fucking self. Okay? Turn on the camera. Record yourself. Talk to yourself. You know? So when you are in a better place, you go back and you think, hey, I was in a bad place, but I got out of it. I know I'm gonna get out of it. I never decide to dwell too long. But it's just, damn, when I go through it, I fucking go through it. Like, I go through a whole 5-stage of grief type thing. Like, it sucks. But anyway, I'm gonna get out this car and get my ass home. I just wanted to do a small car rant with you guys. And guys, this is me being transparent. But, you know, it is what it is. It's going to get better. It's going to take time. It's going to get better. I would like to think so. But that was another reason why I stood in the car, too, because I don't want to do this in front of my kids. I don't want to cry in front of them. And my oldest, my son, is old enough to understand. And so is my oldest daughter. So it's like, I gotta hide my feelings sometimes. And then sometimes I can't help it. But I'm a big crybaby, guys. So, yeah. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. I'll see you guys in another video. Leave you comments down below. Letting me know, like, you know, what y'all do to get through the day when y'all feeling not so good. And just know that you can communicate with me, guys. Be friendly. God damn it, I need friends. Let's get it. Road to 300. Yeah, guys, I'll see you guys in another video. Let me get my shit together. I gotta get out this car. I'm over here wasting gas. So, guys, yeah, see you.